can't touch this. Right. Praise the Lord, because I have found this secret place. This subject of not being touched or having a hiding place, praise the Lord, has to do with being in a safe place as it pertains to our lives. The inner man in particular. Praise the Lord. How many know we have an inner man?
Amen.
The Bible refers to him another place as the hidden man of the heart. That's the part that gets upset. That's the part that people can mess with. That's where you get disturbed. That's where you get attitude. Hallelujah. But I found out that there are places spiritually where believers can go where the enemy can't mess with you.
Amen.
He can look at you, he can roar, he can snort, amen, breathe fire if he wants, but he can't touch you. Praise the Lord. Paul said in Ephesians chapter 3 and verse 16, he said that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might by his Spirit in the inner man. Amen. We put a lot of emphasis on the external part of our lives. That's why we're always topsy-turvy. That's the reason why we're always out of joint, is because we put emphasis on the outer man. The outer man is not where we ought to put the emphasis today. We ought to develop the fella on the inside.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Paul said it this way. He said that though our outward man perish, he said the inward man is renewed day by day. And he said, though our tabernacle of this house be dissolved, he said, we have a building not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. I want to ask the question today, how are you looking on the inside? Somebody say amen. You're looking mighty fine outside. You're looking really good. Your hair's combed and laid right to the side, real nice, parted real good. Hallelujah, your suit is laying just right, the tie's hanging just right. How are you looking, though, on the inside?
Amen.
Because that's the real man.
Yeah.
This fella is going to go.
Amen.
He's perishing even while I'm speaking. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And one brother was preaching the other day in the pulpit, Bishop Bell up in Chicago. He was preaching, and while he was preaching, he collapsed and died in the pulpit. 90 years old, he just, God called him in. But that's no problem if the inside was all right.
Amen.
Because that means, amen, that we'll rise again. Paul said that Christ may dwell in our hearts by faith. Praise the Lord. This inner man that we're developing is a work of faith. We have to develop it by faith. Praise the Lord. We have to create an environment where the Lord will show us this place. We don't know how to get there. But the Lord knows where it is.
Yeah.
And he says that we keep ourselves, amen, until he comes in, amen, and says, I got this. I'll lead you to a secret place. He said that ye may dwell in your hearts by Christ, by faith. That Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith. That ye being rooted and grounded in love. One of the things we're going to have to practice in order for that place to be revealed to us, we're going to have to walk in love.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Our lives are going to have to walk in the love of God.
Amen.
When I don't love like God of love, I'm doing myself a disservice.
Amen.
Somebody say amen. When I love right, I'm conditioning my environment to find the secret place.
Amen.
You can't afford not to love. I can't stand your guts. I hate your guts. I'm saying, God, show me how to love them.
Amen.
Give me the ability to love them.
Amen.
Because if I can love like you say love, you'll show me this secret place.
Amen.
You'll reveal it to me if I can operate by love.
Amen.
The Bible says that faith worketh by love. Our faith won't even operate right if my love is not right. Say amen.
Amen.
He said in the book of Corinthians, 1 Corinthians 13, he said, now abide, amen, faith, hope, and charity, or love, these three. He said, but the greatest of these is charity. So he said that Christ may dwell in our hearts, praise the Lord, while we are rooted, amen, and grounded in love. We've got to love the unlovable. We've got to embrace those folk that's hard to embrace.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Why am I doing it? So he can show me the secret place. I don't want my emotions to be all over the map. Somebody say amen. I don't want to be all over the place with my living. Up and down, sometimes level to the ground. I believe there's a place in Christ that I can get. Praise the Lord, where he can cause my life to be consistent.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
He said, Jesus Christ is the same.
Amen.
Yesterday, today, and forever. And I believe if I can get in the place where Christ resides, then I can be the same.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
You shouldn't see me all over the map. Praise the Lord, if I'm in the secret place. Well, you better leave Bishop alone today. Don't mess with Bishop today. He's got on the wrong side of the bed. Don't mess with him today. Hallelujah! I believe there's a place where I can go, regardless of what happened today.
Amen.
And I can still be pleasant. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I can still be kind.
Amen.
I can still be easy
amen.
To be entreated.
Amen.
Well, how you gonna do it? You gotta get in that hiding place. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Years should not affect your disposition.
Right.
Sometimes people's attitudes is just terrible. It'd be terrible.
Amen.
I'd be like, how come they acting like that?
Amen.
Why are they acting like that? Just mean sometimes. Hallelujah! And I found out, praise the Lord, somebody must be touching you. Hallelujah! The only reason is somebody got through and they touched you.
Yeah.
In your emotions,
mm-hmm.
in your feelings,
yeah.
in your attitude.
Mm-hmm.
But what I'm saying is, Lord, take me to the place. Guide me to the place.
Yeah.
Hallelujah! Show me the place
Hallelujah.
Where the wicked one can touch me now.
Amen.
People gonna mess with you.
Yes, they will.
While you're in this life. Say amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, offenses must come. Care who you are, what family you come from. Offenses must come. And sometimes they come from in the house.
Amen.
All right. Somebody say amen. Sometimes they're on the inside.
Amen.
One that you confide in, the one that you have put your trust in.
Mm-hmm.
They'll be the ones that attempt to touch you the most.
Amen.
But I'm so glad today,
Thank you,
that there's a place, according to John, where the wicked one toucheth us not. Nothing more beautiful than seeing a saint, amen, under pressure, under duress, still living a sweet life. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Ain't nothing more beautiful than seeing a saint of God living that holy life, and you know they're going through.
Amen. Amen.
It's because they have found a secret place.
Amen.
Psalm 91 and 1, the psalmist there said, There is a secret place. Amen. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide. Somebody say abide.
Abide.
Shall abide.
Shall abide
under the shadow, of the Almighty.
Of the Almighty.
Now we have spoken about three places of this secret place. The Bible says in the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word is established. It's established that there's a secret place. Don't come to me talking about, man, I need you to give me some more scripture. I ain't got to give you no more of that right now. I gave you enough already. I gave you three passages that allow us to know there's a secret place. I found out since I've been saved, folk will mess with you. Folk will challenge you. Folk will try you.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And if you're not here, something's going to stand up in you to retaliate.
Amen.
I can get to the secret place.
Hallelujah.
It's like you can see me, but you can't touch this.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want to get to you. I want to cause you to be riled up, but I can't touch you. Bible declares that the devil goes about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. But his teeth has been pulled out. His hands have been taken out by the power of God. All you need is a place where you can hide.
Yes.
When Daniel was in the lion's den, hallelujah, amen, they didn't take the teeth out of the lion. God just caused the lion to lose his appetite.
Right.
Somebody say amen. He was in there where the trouble was, but God hid him. How'd you hide it? He took the nature of the lion out of the lion.
Amen.
Say amen. Amen. Somebody said, no doubt, he used the lion for a pillow.
All right.
Hallelujah. The lion probably grew. God said, shut up, my man's in here. God in essence was saying to the lion, you can't touch this.
Amen.
This is my man, and you can't touch it. The Hebrew boys in that fiery furnace, praise the Lord, and it was heated seven times more than normal. But the heat of the flames did not affect, amen, the bodies. This was natural, the natural bodies of the Hebrew boys. It was almost as if the Lord isolated them and kept them from the damage of the heat. The only thing he let the fire do was burn the restraints off of their hands and their feet. Because the Bible says that when they took the Hebrew boys, they threw them bound into the furnace. The fire was so hot until it slew the men that threw them in. You know that's hot. They opened the door and killed them. But the Hebrew boys, somebody say amen.
Amen.
The Hebrew boys were walking around, and the Bible said, when the king got there and he looked in, he said, we threw three in there. He said, but I see four. Amen. Hallelujah! I see four! And they're walking. The thing that had them bound has been loosed, and they're walking in the flame. And he said, the fourth one is likened unto the Son of God. Praise the Lord. Somebody say, you can't touch this.
Can't touch this.
He that dwelleth in the secret place. I don't want no fictitious, amen, no pseudo hiding place. I want a real place where my soul can hide. Because stuff is going to come at us every single day. Crazy stuff. Seems like stuff that's coming now is crazy. I don't know about your life, but it's crazy stuff coming up now. I'm saying, Lord, show me the secret place. Amen. On your jobs, your co-workers, you ought to need a place where you can go and hide. And I'm not talking about in the bathroom. Hallelujah. I'm not talking about going in the cloakroom. But you're going to need spiritually to be able to find a place where you can go in the midst of all the people. People all around you, but you're still here. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It's interesting how John put it. He said, he that keepeth himself. And we know you can't keep yourself, but what he's talking about, we can put ourselves in a position to be kept. We can't keep ourselves, but we can live so that God will keep us. Amen. Say amen. 1 Peter 1 and 5 says, amen, is that by the power of God through faith unto salvation, amen, that we are kept, ready to be revealed in the last time. The power of God through faith unto salvation, amen, we are kept, ready to be revealed at the last time. Wouldn't it be wonderful to find a place where your emotions, amen, will not be offended, amen, or halted, praise the Lord, a place where we are hid. We got to create an environment that God will inhabit, amen, and provide for us a hiding place. We got to create that environment. You know, when our lives are pleasing in God's sight, his presence is the end result of that. Amen. You don't have to make the presence of God show up. All you have to do is live right. Amen. Somebody say amen. Amen. If we live as we ought to live, God's presence will be there.
Amen.
I've watched people pray over the offering. That was no real, what I would call, spiritual function. There wasn't no Bible class.